This is the game Wild Shapes, which is very similar to Crazy 8's or Uno, which you may have played before. The goal of the game is to match the card in the middle by shape or number, and to be the first player to get rid of all of your cards. This game uses the full shape card deck, including the wild shape cards. To get started, first I'll shuffle the deck and deal 5 cards to each player. Or I might do 8 cards if I was playing with older kids. And this time, let's play with the cards face up, so we can see what's going on. I'll put the rest of the deck face down in the middle and turn over the top card. The first card is 4 circles. So if I'm going first, I'll either need to put down a 4 card or a circle card. I don't have any circle cards, but I do have this 4 rhombus card, so I'll play that. Now the next player goes, and they don't have any 4s or rhombuses, so they have to draw from the center pile. If they can play that card, then they'll go ahead and play it, but if not, you can either just move on to the next player, or you can play that they have to keep drawing from the center pile until they get a card they can play. The other thing a player can do on their turn is they can use a wild shape card to change the shape to one of their choosing. So if I need to match this 6 hexagon card, and I don't have any 6s or hexagons, I can play my wild shape card and say, I'm changing the shape to triangles. And then I can play my 8 triangle card. Now the next player has to either play an 8 card or a triangle card. The game ends when one of the players gets rid of their last card. If you make it through the deck and nobody has gotten rid of all their cards, you can reshuffle the face-up cards and keep going. Also, sometimes playing with a lot of cards in hand can be tough for young kids, so we recommend having each player keep their cards in a shoebox or other similar container. In this game, children are practicing their numeral and shape recognition, but their brains are working on a lot more than that, because they're trying to keep track of the cards in their hand and to follow the constantly changing matching requirement. They're also practicing skills like taking turns and keeping track of what cards other players have. These skills, which support students' approaches to learning, get better with practice.